the fact that he said the word sorry is long overdue. Last week, Jeremy Corbyn had the opportunity to apologise for the comments he made underneath an image which was, I'm afraid, blatantly anti-Semitic. I'm afraid the explanation of, I didn't quite notice it was anti-Semitic, really doesn't wash. I think it was an anti-Semitic image of the type that would be seen in any school history textbook of Nazi propaganda. I think that the sorry for the hurt that's been caused to the Jewish community doesn't quite cut it when, for years now, concerns have been raised directly with Jeremy Corbyn. I have been in some of the meetings with Jeremy Corbyn, with Labour MPs and peers who've relayed the concerns of the Jewish community. I know that Jewish community leaders have met with Jeremy Corbyn to directly relay their concerns. We've seen statement after statement saying that the Labour Party doesn't tolerate anti-Semitism and stands against all forms of racism. And yet we also know that there are countless cases of anti-Semitism that have gone unchecked, language that goes unchecked, a lack of moral clarity and leadership around the tackling of anti-Semitism, which has culminated in the statement I've just read. It's just, you know, been published after 10 p.m. this evening. The statement that's issued by the Board of Deputies for British Jews and the Jewish Leadership Council, which are the leading organisations for the Jewish community in Britain, I think is devastating. It's unprecedented. I think every Labour member and every MP needs to read it and reflect upon it. And the fact that tomorrow evening the Jewish community has organised a demonstration to coincide with a meeting of the Parliamentary Labour Party makes me ashamed to be a Labour MP. And I cannot believe that we are in this position where one of the world's major faith communities in Britain are protesting against my party because we are not just perceived to be soft on tackling anti-Semitism, but in my experience as a Labour MP, we are actually soft when it comes to tackling anti-Semitism. And that sticks in the throat as a Labour MP, because my party has a long and proud history of standing against anti-Semitism, all forms of discrimination. And I think that, you know, to be going into work tomorrow in Parliament knowing that there is going to be this protest, I will be joining that protest outside Parliament, and I'm deeply ashamed it's come to this. This could have been avoided if Jeremy Corbyn had listened to any piece of advice given to him by Labour MPs, peers, Jewish community leaders. I think this is a dereliction of leadership, and I think it's a tragedy we've got to this position.
So, Wes Streeting, are you saying you agree then with the words of the two Jewish bodies that you talked of there? They say, we conclude that Mr. Corbyn cannot seriously contemplate anti-Semitism because he is so ideologically fixed within a far-left worldview that is instinctively hostile to mainstream Jewish communities.
I agree with every single word of that statement, every single full stop and comma.